In this video, we will discuss solenoid and plunger type electromagnetic attraction relay. In solenoid and plunger type relay, you can see the construction. There is an electromagnet consisting of a solenoid, or you can say coil of wire, which is wrapped around an iron core. So this is an iron core. Here the solenoid is a hollow solenoid where the plunger, so this is the plunger. The plunger can be moved upwards through this hollow solenoid. In order to activate the trip circuit, this plunger must be moved upwards to make contact with the trip circuit. You can see a spring which provides restraining force. What is restraining force? Restraining force is the force of a spring which is opposite of the operating force. Now, when supply is given, current flows through the coil. Therefore, coil is energized and magnetic flux is produced. So, when supply is given, magnetic flux is produced like this. And this magnetic flux flows through a closed path, right? Now what happens under normal condition and fault condition? Under normal operating condition, the value of operating current flowing through this coil is very low and magnetic field is generated in the electromagnet due to this low current. The strength of magnetic field generated, or magnetic force you can say, is proportional to the amount of current through the coil. So if the force is F, which is proportional to the square of the current flowing through the coil. So under normal operating condition, the current is normal. This means the current is less, then the operating force, or you can say magnetic force, will be less, since force is proportional to the square of the current. So this amount of force which is produced due to the less amount of current in the normal condition, this force is not strong enough to be greater than the restraining force of the spring. This means under normal condition, the restraining force is greater than operating force. Therefore, the restraining force of the spring keeps the plunger in such a position that it cannot make contact with the trip circuit. So the trip circuit will not be active under normal condition because plunger cannot move upward due to the less amount of magnetic force. Now fault condition, what happens? The value of current, this value I, is very high. If the current is very high, then the operating force will be very high, right? So this high amount of operating force attract the plunger upwards and the plunger make contact with this trip circuit. By this way, the solenoid and the plunger type relay works for opening the moving contact of a circuit breaker under fault condition. And the minimum amount of current at which the plunger gets attracted to close the trip circuit is called the pickup current. Now the working principle of hinged armature tap relay. In hinged armature tap relay, you can see the construction. There is an electromagnet consisting of coil which is wrapped around an iron core. This is iron core. There is a moving armature in this hinged armature type relay. This is the moving armature. One end of this moving armature is connected to a hinge. As the moving armature can be moved, this is the hinge. In order to close the trip circuit, this moving armature must be moved downwards to reduce the reluctance. And if this moving armature moved downwards, then this moving contact will get connected with the fixed contact, and therefore the trip circuit will be closed. You can see a spring here. So this spring provides the restraining force. What is restraining force? Restraining force is the force of a spring, which is the opposite of operating force. And this restraining force keeps the gap between the moving contact and fixed contact under normal operating condition. So it keeps the gap between the moving contact and fixed contact under normal operating condition. You can see a stop here. So what is the function of this stop? This stop is used to reduce the gap between the core and moving armature. This is the gap between the core and moving armature. So this stop is used to reduce the gap between the moving armature and this core. So what happens if the gap becomes high, if the gap becomes more? Then more magnetic energy will be required to close the trip circuit. More magnetic energy will be required to move this moving iron downward, right? This means there will be more magnetic energy needed to close this trip circuit. So when supply is provided to this coil, coil is energized and magnetic flux is produced, right? Magnetic flux is produced. Now what happens under fault condition and normal condition? Under normal condition, the value of input current is very less. So magnetic force generated by the electromagnet, and we know the magnetic force is proportional to the operating current. So under normal condition, operating current is less. This means the magnetic force is also less. And this less magnetic force or operating force is not sufficient to attract this moving armature downwards. So under normal operating condition, basically the restraining force will be high. And due to this restraining force, this moving armature cannot move downwards further to reduce the reluctance. And if this moving armature cannot move downward further, the moving contact cannot get close with the fixed contact, right? On the other hand, what happens during fault condition? During fault condition, the value of current will be high. If the value of current is high, this means the operating force will be high. If the operating force is high, then this moving armature will be moved downwards. And due to this movement of this moving armature downwards, this moving contact of this moving armature will be moved downwards to get connected with this fixed contact. So when moving contact and fixed contact get connected, then the trip circuit will be closed. And if the trip circuit is closed, then trip coil will be energized. And due to the energized of trip coil, it will further open the moving contact of circuit breaker. This is how a hinged armature type relay works. Now, the working principle of balance beam relay. The balance beam relay is also a type of attracted armature type relay. It consists of a beam. There are two electromagnets at two ends. You can see this is one electromagnet and this is another electromagnet. So when current flows through this restraining coil, let's say current IB, magnetic flux is produced. And due to this magnetic flux, magnetic force is produced, which is called the restraining force. And this restraining force pulls the beam downwards in this end. On the other hand, when current flows through this operating coil, let's say current IA, magnetic flux is produced. And due to this magnetic flux, magnetic force is produced, which is called the operating force. And this operating force pulls the beam downwards in this end. The beam is supported at the middle. Here, the operating force or the net operating force is proportional to the difference of current between operating coil and restraining coil. That means the resultant force is proportional to the square of the operating current minus square of the restraining current. This means when operating current will be greater than the restraining current, then operating force will work to energize the trip coil. If restraining current is greater than operating current, then the beam will deflect in this side and this will not energize the trip coil. Under normal operating condition, the restraining force and operating force are equal. So there will be no net force under normal operating condition. And the beam remains horizontal under normal operating condition. On the other hand, what happens during fault condition? During fault condition, the operating current IA is greater than IB. Operating current is greater than restraining current. And this produces enough operating force and this beam gets deflect downward in this end, in this operating side. And due to this deflection in this operating side, the moving armature fitted at end of this beam gets pulled down and makes contact with the contact of the trip circuit. Thus, the trip circuit operates. You can see a control spring which keeps the gap between the moving contact and fixed contact of the relay under normal operating condition. So this is how a balanced beam relay works to close the trip circuit. Now, the working principle of polarized moving iron type relay. In polarized moving iron type relay, there are two magnets. One is electromagnet and another is already installed a permanent magnet. When current flows through the coil, magnetic flux is produced. On the other hand, there is already a magnetic flux due to the permanent magnet. Now, if the direction of magnetic flux produced in electromagnet and the direction of magnetic flux produced by permanent magnet are same, then the resultant flux will be the sum of both fluxes. So if direction of both flux are same, then the resultant flux will be the sum of both flux. Due to this sum of both fluxes, high magnetic energy will be produced. And due to this high magnetic energy, moving armature will be attracted faster, which means operating time will be less and sensitivity will be increased. On the other hand, if the direction of magnetic flux produced by permanent magnet and the direction of magnetic flux produced by electromagnet are opposite, then the resultant flux will be decreased. Due to this decrease of net flux, magnetic energy will be decreased. This means polarized moving iron type relay will only operate if the direction of both fluxes are same. This provides directional feature of the relay. Due to this directional feature, polarized moving iron type relay is basically used in DC systems.